Good morning and welcome to the Adobe Sign ProjectWise integration training module. Today we're going to show you in a short video how the integration with Adobe Sign and ProjectWise works so that you don't have to take a file out of ProjectWise to put it in Adobe Sign for electronic signature execution and then manually put it back in ProjectWise. That process is all seamless. So if you look on screen, you'll see on the blue line is the file that we're going to use today. It's a very small file. It's only a single page from a record set of specs, an actual project. But before we start, I wanted to point one thing out to you. If you look down at this file here, you'll notice that it's 99 megs. It over here on the right. You don't have to remember that. You just need to be aware of the fact that Adobe Sign can handle a 50 megabyte file, so this one wouldn't work. But even if you didn't have your view set up for that particular file where you could see its size and you tried to execute it, an error message would come up. So I'm going to demonstrate that before we use the other file. So if I right click on this, the process to initiate the Adobe Sign signature process is down at the bottom. And if you hit the little caret here to make the options come up, you'll see one of the options here is send for Adobe Sign signature web edit. That's how you initiate the process. So I'm going to do that on this large file. This box is generated by the integration and basically tells you what document is going to be sent for signature to Adobe Sign. If more than one document were selected, say these were several small files, it would pick the name of the first file to be representative of the three. This line here is the signer message, or what will appear in the email in Adobe Sign to the recipients who are going to sign it. So if I hit OK, notice what happens. I get an error message that says the total size of the file selected is over 50 megabytes. Please select fewer files or compress the selected files to get your package size below the 50 megabytes and resubmit. So this is a case where if you didn't know the size and you got this message, the file needs to be broken up. There's other small snippet videos which we're producing which will show you how to break up files that are too large and reassemble them after they've been signed. So that's how the process works if the file is too big. Now we're actually going to start the process to show you how the integration works on this single page file. So right click on a file or files that you want to send. And then down at the bottom where it says send for Adobe Sign signature web edit, click that. The message comes up that you just saw. I'm not going to fill in the signer message. I'm going to do that in Adobe Sign, so I'm just going to leave that blank. The file is the one I selected, so all I have to do is hit OK. Notice when I do that, a message comes up and says, agreement creation was sent. Watch your email for a link to the web authoring interface. So it's just basically telling you, go to your email and wait for the indication that the file's been transferred from ProjectWise to Adobe Sign, and the process is about to begin. So I'm going to go to my email. Minimize that. All right, so if I look in my email, I already have a file. It says it's a signed file, sent documents for signing. It's the very top one. So I'm going to select it. And this is the message you'll receive. Basically says navigate to this location here and begin the setup of the signature process. So it automatically brings you into Adobe Sign in the send environment, which is where you set the document up. So the document's been transferred automatically from ProjectWise to Adobe Sign. And here is the document that was just transferred, but there's no message. Remember, I left that blank. So since this has to do with record sets, I'm going to select a message template here that's appropriate, which in fact is sealing record sets. Message to recipients. So now I have the typical record set language that's going to appear in the email. But before I go any further, there's one thing that's important to remember from the training that you got on using Adobe Sign. I'm the only person that's going to sign this as the guinea pig resident or guinea pig engineer. So if I'm going to send it to myself, you remember you have to use recipient group. You can't send it to yourself because it won't work. It takes two signatures, and the way you get around that, if you remember, is to add a recipient group. But the first thing you have to do is to get rid of this single email up here, which is outside of the recipient group, or you'll get an error message. So I'm going to delete that. My email was put in there automatically by the integration process. And if I was going to send this to two different or more unique people, that's where I would have started, and my address would have automatically been put in there like you see. But I'm going to delete that because I'm going to send it only one recipient, me. So I've got to remove that and use only the recipient group. So I'm going to call this group name ABC. I'm going to enter in my email address, which pops up because it's been entered before. And then if you recall from your training, the trick is the other address is your address with a plus one just before the at state.co.us. So if I start typing that, I've already done that before. There it is with the plus one. Select that. So now it's set up to be sent to one recipient only for signing. There's the text, what to sign. We haven't told it what, so I'm just going to copy this name, paste it down here so in the email it appears. And it's ready to go. I'm not going to set a reminder for myself because I'm going to do it right now. If you were sending it to someone else, you probably would do that. So when I hit next, go to the authoring environment, which you should be used to as the document sent to the cloud. And here we are. So I'm going to blow this up so you can see it easier. Remove the bar by getting rid of the X. And notice, since a recipient group allows anyone to sign on behalf of half of the group, I don't need to check my name or anyone else's that might be here. It's already set up for that by the ABC recipient group being checked. So I don't have to do anything there. All I need to do, since this is one page of a record set, is to set up the template or use the template to put the seal and the scope of authority limitation down there. So over here on field templates, we want to select one. And we're going to select the project special provisions participant number one. Number one because there's basically only one person that needs to seal this. If there were two, for instance, this one would be first, and this one here would be for the second recipient. So I'm going to select that, hit apply, and there it is. Now it's set up for two, so you can have at least two engineers sign this, which occasionally happens. Sometimes it's more than that for a set of special provisions, which this is a part of. And that's the reason it's on the right side, so that it would be centered if there were another engineer that had to sign it. But I want this in the center, so if you remember from your training, you hold down the shift key, select the date field first, then select the stamp, then the text, and move all three into the center. And that looks much better. So this document's ready for me to sign it. So I'm going to hit send. And I get a message that just tells me it's been sent to the recipient, who is me. Could be a notification in my email inbox. But before I go to my email, I'm just going to hit the manage button here so I can see that if you'll notice, let me update this by hitting the F5 key. Notice there's one document out for signature right here, and that's the one sent to me. Here it is. It's on the way. So I'm going to my email. And there's the invitation to sign that one-page document. There it is. Just like it says, notice you see down here, if you look at the little graphic, you see the default text, but there's no seal yet because it hasn't been signed. So just like it says, click here to review and sign. I'm going to click that. and here's the message, what I'm supposed to do. This would be true if it went to a consultant. If you want to read the message, didn't have time, just click the little button here for the default message. It brings it up again, what the task is. So I'm going to hit start, like we always do to sign an electronic document. It tells me to enter the scope of my authority, which I'm going to say is selection of project special provisions. Like so. And then I'm going to hit next. It's asking for my seal. I'm going to click on that. It says, well, where is your seal? So it's going to be an image. Click that. I'm going to click select stamp. And the stamp I want to use is this test blank seal. In your case, it would be it would have a signature over the seal. This is a blank. There it is. Hit apply. It's done. So we've got the seal in the center. The date's automatic. There's the scope limitation. Click here to sign, to complete the signing. And it tells me it's done. It's complete. So the question is, let's have a look here. And did it in our manage environment, and did it get into ProjectWise successfully? Because Adobe Sign is supposed to send that executed document back to ProjectWise. So let's check our email. There's a new message. I click on it. It tells us in the title that this document is signed and filed or placed in ProjectWise. If I clicked on that, it would take me to the file. But I've already got ProjectWise up, so I'm going to open it up, hit F5 to refresh the screen. And notice I've got one right here that says it's signed. It's a duplicate of this one above, but it's signed. So that tells you it's complete. If I try to open it up, it says this is a read-only file. So I'll say, yeah, let's open it anyway. So if I open it up and have a look, this is the file in ProjectWise. It's automatically placed back in there. There's the scope limitation, the date, the seal, and here is the appended audit trail for that document. Every document that's done this way will have the audit trail on who signed what and when, and even list the completion of the document at the bottom. So you get a notification that it not only is the process complete as far as e-signatures, but when the workflow is complete in that the document has been stored in ProjectWise, signed and completed with the audit trail. So that's the completion of this short video that shows you how to use the Adobe Sign ProjectWise integration for the automatic movement of a file back and forth between ProjectWise and the execution of the document. Thank you very much. Bye.